In 1988, I wrote a musical called The Torn Curtain. It had 8 songs that took us through the tabernacle into the most holy place. And then we put a communion, an Anglican communion service on setting at the end of it. And that was 1988, and a lot's happened since then. Even the Church of England has redone its communion, and we've re-looked at it, and we let The Torn Curtain lapse a bit, didn't know what to do with it. And then earlier this year, in 2019, we suddenly thought, let's rejig it. So what we've done is we've separated the communion service from the Torn Curtain musical, shall we call it, and here we've got it. It's a new musical. It's got now 11 songs, because we've added 3 at the end, and we've re-recorded every song, rewritten it, thought about it again, and we've even got some great soloists on it and some great instrumentalists on it. So what we're doing today here at the Coton Centre in Tamworth is we're giving it a premiere. We've got a huge orchestra, we've got a huge choir, and we've got some fabulous soloists, and we really, it's like doing a musical in a day, and we're going to put this musical on today with a final production. The amazing thing is that we've got our friends from all directions have come, from all over the country, from north, south, east and west, some even from Wales, have come in order to be part of Torn Curtain as we put it on today.
Thank you. in the Lord is reflected in our whole being. His joy reaches our emotions, his love can touch our innermost feelings, his life can flow through our bodies, making us sing and dance together as we move into his courts with praise. Even at the time of Jesus, when a more permanent temple had replaced the tabernacle, there was still the curtain that came between the people and the most holy place, a symbol of the division that stood between a holy God and sinful human beings. There was nothing we could do to remove that barrier, but God took the initiative, and in his great love, he sent his son Jesus to die on the cross. For as the writer to Hebrews says, when Christ came as high priest, he went through the greater and more perfect tabernacle. He entered the most holy place once for all by his own blood.
Thank you.
Bible says the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin. And when Jesus died with this amazing visual aid, God confirmed that this sacrifice was sufficient to remove the barrier that stood between us and him. And Matthew writes in his gospel, and when Jesus had cried out again in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. So again, as the writer to Hebrews put, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain, that is, his body. And since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near to him with a sincere heart and full assurance of faith. Let us hope unswervingly in the hope we profess. For he who promised is faithful.
See your arms held wide.
with a Samaritan woman at a well. Jesus said that the Father is seeking worshippers who will worship him in spirit and in truth. So now, as we come before him now in the most holy place, we worship together.
Thank you.
you just to stay there for a moment, in the most holy place, all because of Jesus. To rest in his presence, to know him, to know his love. Thank you. For the most holy place is a safe place, where we can rejoice and relax in the presence of the one who is both our lover and our saviour. It's a foretaste of heaven, where we will forever be with him, our light and our salvation.
Yeah.
come towards the end of our musical. It reminded me that years ago, the Lord said to us, what is the heart of worship and the heart of the music ministry? It's tell my people I love them. And if people could get that message, it would change the world. Actually, it would change the church. In the depth of our being. Alison Fugle's up there, who wrote the words of that song that we put in the torn curtain, because it felt right that that's what we'll hear when we're in the most holy place. You know, we say to folks, and of course we're particularly suffering the death of our chairman of our trust this week, Jeff, and we think about the words rest in peace. I want to tell you, rest in peace is going to be very active. When you say to someone rest in peace, it's going to be the best you can ever imagine, and better still. And all because of Jesus. If we know him, we can be sure that the best is yet to come. And being in the most holy place through the tearing of that curtain is just a foretaste of the glory that is to come. Because, oh, how good is the God we adore. Let us continually offer to God a sacrifice.